everybody. I discovered something today in Figma that I did not know was possible, and I wanted to share it with you immediately. So I stopped the video I was working on to bring you this. Now, I've seen plugins that do skewing like this, but until today, I was not aware that you could do it in a non-destructive way and maintain these distorted images' linkage to where they came from. If you don't believe me, look at this. How cool is that? I had no idea this was possible in Figma. Let me very quickly walk through the steps to do this. I'm going to take an instance of my component. I'm going to rotate it 45 degrees. I'm going to hit Command G, group, to give it a fresh bounding box on the outside. I want to make the height 50% of what it currently is. So I'm just going to go divided by 2 on the height. That gives me a perfectly squished rectangle now. I rotate this 60 degrees back, and I'm very close to having an isometric cube face that's perfect. Now, if Figma was doing its math correctly, this would fit perfectly. It's not quite right, so I can tinker with it by just tweaking the results from that operation like so, and it fits quite well to the template I built. Then, of course, you repeat it with slightly different rotations and skewings on the other faces, and you've got yourself an isometric cube. So that's cool to begin with, but the fact that it's still connected to the original component is what blows my mind. I did not know that was possible. And in case you're wondering how to create a template like this, it's pretty simple. It's just a polygon. I change the sides up to 6. I hit return to put it into edit mode, hit P to go to pen mode. Click on the opposites, another one here, and another one here. Hit return, remove the fill, add a stroke, add some weight. You got yourself a template. So you can use this to help get your faces just right. Okay. You might wonder if this works on more complicated components. And you can see here from this example, I'm just going to go down to this row of my nav bar and just move it around, and you'll see that it's also updating on the right in the two distorted instances. I can't believe this, but there it is. You might also wonder if this works with images, and it does, as long as you turn off this locked aspect ratio. As long as it's unlocked, it works great. So here it is. When it's unlocked, I can rotate and then group, so I get the new bounding box, distort it a bit, and then I can rotate it back or do whatever I need to do. You'll notice though that sometimes it will trim a little bit off the bottom as you're playing. You might have to go back in after the fact and just adjust the inner bounding box a little bit. It's not flawless, but it's very close and you can always go in and correct it. Now you've got yourself an image that's distorted nicely. And finally, one of the strangest things that I discovered in the middle of all this, here remember we built this isometric face here. And it's in a group, which allows me to change its bounding box. If I ungroup, so I've lost that outer bounding box, and I rotate it back to the way it started here, so the bottom is horizontal, I've got myself a skewed box. Now, Figma doesn't support skew, and yet not only do I have a box that's skewed, it honors the skew as I move the sides. And this is still linked to the original component, so I can make changes in it as well. This is really interesting because there's no setting whatsoever on the properties panel that indicates that this is skewed. The only way this happened was because we took a shape, we rotated it, we put it in another group, we distorted it, and then we ungrouped it. And well, I guess we also rotated it back. And now we have a skewed, it's crazy. Even the handles are skewed to indicate that that's what's going on. So I don't know how Figma managed to squeeze this feature in without offering any way to control it here on the side panel, but it's awesome. I stumbled on this feature when I was building this content on masks, and I discovered sort of by accident that I had created a component where the mask was actually being updated live even in my distorted instances, which I did not expect to work. Everything seems to work in these. Even prototyping behaviors like hovers and animation all work in the distorted frame after you've built it this way. Yeah, after I found this today, I had to create a video right away to share it with you. So I hope you enjoyed that. And please reach out if you have any questions or ideas of more content you'd like to see from me, subscribe, of course, and I'll talk to you again real soon.